All right, well, welcome to this month's masterclass lesson. Actually, this is going to be an interesting video this month.
Yeah.
Oh, you guys want to introduce yourselves over
sure.
here?
Okay, I'm Carly, and maybe you know me from a few videos or so now.
If you've been with us for a while, yep.
Yeah, to any new faces, I'm Carly. I'm from San Diego, but I'm living in Nagasaki, Japan right now.
Next.
I'm Natasha. I went to school at San Diego State University with Carly. I'm originally from the Bay Area, and she actually connected me with Drew, and I interned for him for a while.
Yep, she did a little bit of help, and so we actually had a great evening today talking about lots of different business-related things and customer service, because she's really interested in that kind of thing, as it's great for learning more about business and helping people get what they need from whatever that was. But we were just sitting here talking. You want to hold up this book here? So this is a book about Japan. She came out to visit Carly. You're out here for what, a week or
10 days?
10 days.
Yeah.
So did you read this whole book?
I skimmed through this whole book. Yeah. I didn't read it word for word, but I definitely kept picking
you found
out,
the interesting
the different sections.
Sure,
yeah.
Sure.
Yeah.
So we were just sitting and talking about like men and women and like other things like that, just, you know, coming from a different cultural thing. Like you probably heard about like men, like the subway cars are, and the train cars are pretty packed.
Yeah, and there's women-only ones.
So there are women-only cars out here in Japan as well, just to make sure people don't get groped or, you called it, what, grazing someone?
Grazing.
So you told a story about a woman getting, like, her breast got grazed or something, so man,
she's really upset, and how, like... I shouldn't be laughing, but Drew, so Drew said, like, oh, I wish women could do that to men.
I was just saying, like, kind of joking, like, you know, why don't women try to just grope men more, like, out, because you don't see that often, especially not in Japan, like, you know, it would be pretty rare for, like, a woman to hit on a man out here.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you might see that more with a Japanese woman and a foreign guy, maybe just because they understand a little bit more about Western culture, and that's a more...
Right.
Funny that you mention that, though. In this book, Japan Made Easy, it talks about how girls are not taboo, but ... It starts off saying that it's common knowledge that Western men find Oriental women unusually attractive, and that in any ranking of overall femininity, character and personality, Japanese women are invariably in the top three. But it goes through
What are the other two in the top three?
Yeah, I'm curious.
I'm not sure.
Yeah.
Oh, so it doesn't list that. It just says they're in the top three, but it doesn't say
what the other two are.
You can't do that in a book. Yeah. You're supposed to give like all of the tops.
I'm curious.
But it pretty much says, like, male guests from other countries visiting Japan, the Japanese men and cultures, they are very protective of their women, and if they are going to engage in, like, flirting or sexual encounters or anything, it's going to be with the entertainment business. So they're very kind of, that's what it talks about.
When was that written? Because I haven't found that to be the case out here.
No. 1999, updated in a copyright 1995, updated in 1999.
Okay. Well, it's almost 10 years. 20 years, really. 1999.
Oh my god, about 20 that. Years. It's good to know. I know.
But I was like 10 years.
But I mean, the culture has definitely changed more about that. But I certainly haven't found any Japanese men being particularly like protective of women that are not dating them specifically, so they wouldn't just walk up like, oh, like, you talking to our women or whatever. I've never experienced
I wonder
like
if
that.
It's just if you're here for a short period of time, you're like, all right, I'm just looking for party or like the nightlife.
Maybe.
Or,
but I get, depending on your level of Japanese, I guess I I've never had any experience like that. But so we're just sitting talking about that, about like, you know, the differences in men and women, and it's also something I thought would be an interesting topic, because culturally in countries like America and the United Kingdom and Australia, there are a lot of like now there's a lot more discussion about equality and men and women and how they relate to each other and what should we be doing in business situations and things like that.
Like, should women make the first move?
And that's, so that's another thing, like relationship-wise, what do you think about that? Can you, if you see a guy at a at the club or whatever, and you're, you know, like or at the grocery store or something, would you feel comfortable making the first move?
I don't know. I guess I just grew up in a more conservative environment, but also there's the some of the things that guys ask nowadays, and like
in, what do you mean,
online dating or like even like just regular, I'm like, I can't believe you just asked me to like do this or do that, you know? And I'm like, do other girls really? I can't give an example right now, but like, for example, you mean like they'll say
like sexual thing, like
not very necessarily sexual. It's just so like they think that they're being light and flirting and stuff, or like
it's just weird.
Like they'll talk about me in a third person or something. We have we've only been on like one date or something.
Well, you need to explain to people what that means.
Like they'll say, "Oh, it sounds like Tosh is." It sounds like Tosh is really likes this, or like talking about me like in a third person, you know.
And she dating somebody who would like message her back and talk to her in the third person. It was really weird.
Just say one word, like, oh, like asking about if you took a flight or a drove to a certain location they were traveling to, and like they told me they were flying, and I go, oh, nice. And they go, how many times are you gonna call me nice? And I'm like,
that's so weird. That's just, your way of flirting.
I'm
dude?
Not
this
impressed.
Is this is somebody you met like personally or
through friends,
and you don't speak with this person
anymore. It was just a bit of a turn off. I just you know, I have people who tell me like, oh, don't be such a prude, like they were just being nice, flirting, but I just feel like for me
it's not
like,
vibing then.
Maybe I don't like I can't game, tell if it's really I can't tell if it was just my personal preference or if that was something that other people wouldn't enjoy either. So you guys tell me what your thoughts are on
It sounds like he has no game, really.
Yeah, no game, and is an awkward person, and doesn't know how to socialize with women properly. Sure.
Well, I think, but this is a problem with men now. Like, men and women, they're kind of, we used to have, like, what you're talking about, a bit more traditionally defined roles, or people understood, like, men are maybe more the aggressor, not like in a bad way, but they're they approach. And so women are there, and this is kind of biologically where we're coming from, like the I guess I have more of like an evolutionary biology way of looking at it. So if you just look at the like the different sexes in general, so you have eggs and you have a limited supply of them. So it's your job to be choosy. But my job, like, I have
millions
I could make millions of little like sperms or whatever, and so, you know, it's okay. We can talk about this. We can be adults over here.
Yeah, I know.
Exactly. Actually, everybody. I think there's a few people in the program actually in high school, but
they're probably really enjoying this topic.
But it's important to learn. You will see it in movies and TV shows, and people talk. It's just normal conversational stuff.
This is the real talk.
So, yeah.
Well, here's the thing too, just based off of my personal experience growing up, that stuff was kind of hidden from me.
Sure.
So I think if it would have been there more often and talked about more often, it wouldn't be so different or not awkward, and I don't feel awkward, but like it wouldn't be something that I feel should not be talked about
more openly.
Exactly. I mean, even like
Well, feel free to talk about it now. See, I try to think about it in a scientific way when I'm talking about it. Like,
we have limited supplies of our materials per se.
And not only that, but I mean, even like, I mean, you have a period every month, so you got that like one egg, and there's a like 400 of them, or however many you've got for
until menopause. Yes.
And you can only produce a child, you know, it's 9 months gestation period, and you got to raise the child really before doing another one. So you have a very limited supply. So you have to be choosier.
Yeah, about who we make a baby with.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. But I think like women now, like, you know, they're contraceptives and, you know, women can have more fun or they can not have more fun. But do you think with, I mean, because I've been out of America for a while. I mean, I follow the news or things that happen in the United States. But like, since Natasha, you're still living out there, are you noticing more people feel like men and women are becoming more equal? Or is that making a difference in the way people interact with each other?
I would say I'm really lucky to be in California where there is more equality between men and women. Even in like the workplace, people are like, okay, let's talk, let's see what the women's side of, like perspective is, you know, or it's not just the men. I do think that women have come a long way and there's still a lot more to be done, but just going somewhere more rural or like more towards the Midwest and, or even going to another country like in Greece, you know, like it just seems like there's so much more opportunity where I've grown up in terms of where women's voices are definitely diminished. And so I do feel like it's come a long way in California and, you know, city areas and everything.
Do you think that like some changes of the
things you hear? Oh, yeah.
Do you think that changes dating in any way? Like
more women getting into the workplace, and that's affecting the way men and women relate to each other, you mean? Or you're just talking about equality socially in general?
Yeah, like socially in general, like it would it be more normal in California for a woman to approach a man than vice versa? I think it would, right? It's a little bit different.
It's more open, like you could. I would say that you can approach a guy, but I think that there's also the feeling of letting the guy feel like a guy. They like to do those things, you know. Sometimes now that I think about it, there are times where I'm the first one or like I'm like trying to reach out and everything,
but I don't want to make some really flirty eyes
I'm showing you I'm interested and I'm like either I'm being sorely rejected or they really just like they have to do it on their own too, like sometimes you know, or like there have been guys like I've dated where I'll make more of the first moves and then
well that's common. I mean like women typically, like if a man walks into a bar and there are women there and he's kind of looking around
who
looks friendly, who is providing some kind of indication, an invitation of some sort, like whatever women do if you pay attention to that, then it's really up to you to make a move at that point.
Yeah, but then sometimes when I feel like I made a move, like I feel like, oh, maybe that was too strong. Like, wasn't that supposed to be like his kind of like?
But that's what I'm saying. I think like a lot of the changes that are happening socially are contributing to making that more difficult for men. So if they feel like some places, I mean, and again, like I'm kind of out of touch as far as like actually living in the United States or a place where you have that, because the culture is still, it's a bit more traditional still out here in Japan, kind of like what the book was talking about. But if men feel that they're going to be, called out for sexual harassment or something, like if you kind of look at me, I'm like, all right, maybe she wants me to make a move, and I walk over and you're like, why are you talking to me or whatever? And I think something like that. So it's because the socially understood rules are a little bit different now.
Right.
Do you feel that? Does that make sense, or you don't really notice that?
I don't notice it. Yeah. I've never heard a story where you hear a guy complain about a girl making moves or being too strong.
I don't mean about like a man complaining about a woman approaching. I mean, men might even, but especially if you're interested in the woman. Like the worst is when, if you're not interested in someone, like a woman, and they're approaching you, you're like, oh, I feel bad, if I'm not interested or whatever. Yeah. But the just men feeling a bit more nervous about approaching a woman in general.
Gotcha.
I think the Bay Area is a pretty special case, because there is such a you got so many more men than women out there now. So women have it much better, like dating-wise or whatever, than men do out there.
So you're saying that guys now are feeling like they are holding back more because women like are kind of evolving to become...
Well, that's what I hear, or kind of what I see online or in on just news when I hear people talking about things like that, because I'm not out there. So I'm asking more because you're there. Do you notice anything like that, or does it not seem like it's...
No, I mean, I've heard of that too, now that I think about it, but I haven't actually experienced or noticed that.
Huh. Well,
yeah. Have you?
Not too much. Yeah.
Well, what do you...
Women are being... sticking up for themselves more if they feel harassed. Mm-hmm. Whereas, like, in the past, maybe they just kind of, like, go with it and not say anything. Yeah.
So women are becoming more assertive.
Yeah, they're becoming more assertive about, like, needing respect or space if they're not interested in the guy. So it can lead to some sticky situations, you know, if, like, a guy does, like, push himself to touch her on her shoulder or elbow or whatnot in kind of like a safer area. But if she doesn't like it, like, the woman has full right to be like, don't touch me, like, get away, you know? So, like, I can see why maybe some guys are afraid to approach women, but, like, they should, I don't know, they should just, like, have more of a social intuition, I guess. But not everybody has that, you know?
Sure. Well, it's a thing you kind of have to develop, I suppose.
Yeah.
It takes learning how to, like, that courtship of meeting women, going out, talking to women, and, you know, if you're, you know, developing that game.
Mm-hmm.
And I just wonder now, again, I'm not any kind of authority to talk about it because I'm not living out there. I'm not young and dating anyway. Mm-hmm. But I'm just curious because I see about that and people complaining about that online.
Mm-hmm.
So now you have more, like, you know what MGTOW is? You ever heard of that?
MGTOW.
So MGTOW is an acronym for men going their own way.
Men going their own way.
So this is men. There's a growing community of men that, like, they're feeling ostracized or, like, socially that they don't, like, it's like getting harder socially to even approach women. Like, maybe years ago, like a less attractive guy or somebody, you know, could try to approach women and wouldn't get shot down as quickly or something like that. But now, like, only what would be considered, like, an alpha male, like, you know what an alpha male is?
Yeah.
So that idea,
really hot,
like, so good looking or, like, socially very, like, high status, that kind of person.
Well, here's the thing. I feel like in the Bay Area, at least, there's a lot of online dating nowadays.
Sure.
So there's so many different apps. It doesn't even seem like you really hit on someone at a bar or, like, you meet somebody. I mean, you still meet people through friends and stuff like that, but it just seems a lot rarer. Like, if you're,
Using these apps now, or are you
here and there? Sure. I wouldn't say but just
how's
from
your
my
experience been?
Yeah, I mean, it's like I said, here and there. Met a few good eggs, a few bad eggs, but. I feel more comfortable getting to know the person, like, being able to gauge, like, oh, is this somebody I actually want to invest my time spending with and getting to know, even for, like, a first meetup, you know? And then every person I have met, luckily, actually has been a good egg, but the bad eggs, I'm like, I'm not even going to bother wasting my time, messaging online.
So how do you, what are you using, Tinder or something? Or?
Tinder, no.
Oh, no?
That's a little bit too risque for me.
Oh, really? No, I've not used any dating app ever. Like, I remember actually meeting people back on America Online, like, many, I know, it's like old, like, pen pals and stuff way back in the day. But thinking about that now, why not Tinder? I guess I don't know much about it. I know you just swipe left or right on pictures, and if you connect with someone and it lets you communicate with that person.
Mm-hmm. Well, each app almost has a reputation. Tinder's reputation is, okay, I'm looking for a hookup for that night.
Or
that weekend, or something quick, you know?
Uh-huh.
Like, I mean, there are rare stories where the people do meet on Tinder and then they end up getting married and, you know, end up dating a lot longer and everything. But, Tinder.
But that's the rare exception.
I try to stay
away.
Yeah, exactly. I don't try to stay away. I just don't. I don't.
Huh. Yeah. Oh, really? So what would you recommend for women that are trying to actually have a connection with a guy?
Or... Yeah, there's an app called Bumble.
Okay. All right, I've heard,
heard
of
Bumble. Yeah, yeah, exactly. The girl can reach out first to the guy.
Oh, really?
And
interesting.
Yeah. So, usually my go-to is, hey, how's it going? So, yeah, happy face.
Yeah.
Or, like, I'll try to figure something out from, like, maybe a picture that interests me or, like, I can connect with, you know.
Yeah. Like the picture of you in the trees. Where did you go camping?
Oh, well, there you go.
Do you like to spend time outside?
Yeah, or it's so cool you're an astronaut. Like, yeah. Are you really an astronaut?
That would be cool, but are you really an astronaut?
Yeah, you just...
Well, that's a great opener anyway, even if they're not. Like, they could just be out, like, walking your dog or whatever. Yeah. Like, oh, I didn't know you were an astronaut.
They have the business title, or, like, what they're working and doing and everything, and they're like, yeah, astronaut at NASA, and I'm like... Okay. We matched. I feel pretty cool. Uh-oh. Like, I can go on a date with an astronaut.
Like, up in space, you know.
Yeah.
That'd be
that
a cool
would be
date.
Romantic.
I've always wanted to go to a coffee shop on the moon with a view of planet Earth.
That would be beautiful.
There
that
you
would
go.
Be
that's a good business idea right there.
Out of this world. Yeah, great business idea, right? Once Elon Musk, you know, gets all his life... ideas to build a civilization on Mars. Yeah. Maybe there can be some transportation to the moon.
Yeah.
I think we would do the moon first. You know, it's a little bit closer.
A lot closer, isn't it? Yeah, that's a good idea, Drew.
Let's do it.
It's like, let Elon have Mars, you know.
I'll take the moon.
Yeah. We'll get to the moon first. Well, are you seeing anybody right now, or you don't want to divulge that, or is that, uh-oh. We can gloss over that one.
We can gloss over that one. Nice try, though, Drew.
I don't know. I don't know if that special someone, if there is one, would probably not be watching this video anyway. But how did you?
Unless I share it with them.
If you did meet such a person, where would you have met them? Would that be through Bumble or through just?
Bumble, Coffee Meets Bagel.
Those two.
Yeah, I would say Coffee Meets Bagel and Bumble. Coffee Meets Bagel, they give you like a bagel of the day. They call it a profile. Bagel equals profile in this case.
And what's coffee? That's a euphemism something.
I guess it just says the coffee meets bagel, so they pair well together. So they're looking for like your taste, maybe. That's just my assumption. I'm not exactly sure, but that's what I'm getting.
Oh, I was thinking like the bagel meant like a woman or something like that for some reason.
Yeah.
Because like a...
I heard of one app on Instagram. Like, I don't know if it's true or just like a fake thing, but like they take these that... like super duper great profiles and feature them. So there's only like 21 men per month or something like that. And basically you have to like enter to win like a date with these awesome guys. Like
it's like Bachelor's.
Yeah.
The Bachelor online.
Yeah, only like an app. Right. I know.
Innovative.
So, it is so innovative.
You've tried this before?
I haven't tried it. I was just kind of flipping through my phone and saw that and skimmed over the information and made my own, like, assumptions about it. So, I could be way off, but...
You don't remember the name of it?
I don't remember the name. But that sounds fun. Like, if I could go on a date with a really nice guy, I would be really happy about that.
Well, that's what I was mentioning before about like the dating strategies of men and women, like just from like thousands of years ago. You talk about like how because of the way we reproduce, so a woman is going to be more inclined to be choosy, and like because you're choosy, you want to meet the best person you can.
And would a dude be like, oh, she's cute, okay.
Basically.
Yeah.
Well, what's awesome about the app is you can scroll through profiles and you can be like, all right, I'm more interested in that, especially when you're really busy.
That seems like it's a big
That's a big appeal.
Yeah.
Especially when you're going through your 20s, you're trying to build up your career or... you know, build up your hobbies, this and that. So it's like, where can you fit your romance. Sometimes people are too busy.
So yeah, well, that's interesting you bring that up, though. So, I mean, both of you are working and you're, you know, young ladies. Are you thinking about you want to have kids in the future, or do you care? Is that a priority to balance that out, or not really, or what do you think?
More in the future. You know, I definitely feel like now, like, I really want to focus on my career. I haven't thought that far ahead, to be honest. I mean, one day, yes, but I think maybe you have a better idea on what you want. For me, I'm career, you guys are how old? Career focused.
25.
24.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so I would like to have children, but, like, honestly, I'm just going to be doing my own thing until Mr. Right shows up. And, like, I can have a child maybe 28 to 37. Like, there's a wide, wide window. I'm ready for, like, whatever comes at me. But definitely I want to be financially stable, be with the right person, and make sure, like, I am healthy. Yeah. So, if those things are, like, checked off, and both me and my partner feel ready, then, like, that's when I could have a child. But I definitely do want children. And I want to adopt, at least.
Like, oh, really?
Yeah, I want to.
It's really interesting.
Oh, you want to adopt also? Or?
Well, actually, I grew up in a family that was really involved with foster family, the Foster Family Network.
Oh, are you adopted?
It's a complicated story, but, you know, I have, siblings who have been adopted, and, a lot of kids have come into our house and home due to, like, neglect or drug issues with their family and everything. Mm-hmm. But, just going back based off of what you mentioned in terms of evolution, like, my grandma, I call her Yaya, she had her, like, first child at 17.
Sure.
And, like, you know, a lot of civilizations, I don't know, like, different societies and everything. Sure. Back in the day, it's like, hey, you get married, you have children, you're the child bearer, you know, the woman is sweeping around the house, trying to look for the American dream, white picket fence, cook for the husband once he comes home. But nowadays it's like both the man and the woman are providing, or sometimes you even see and hear about, like, men staying home and the women going out. Mm-hmm. And,
stay at home getting, dad.
Yep. Yeah, staying at
my
home.
Dad.
Yeah. And then, like, now it's like we think, okay, what are we going to do right now? How far in the future are we going to plan out when we're going to have kids? Or are we even thinking about that at all? Are we continuously pushing that back and everything, you know? So it is interesting to think about the mindset. And even now people my age are having kids and getting married. I'm thinking, aren't you still so young for that? But it really just depends on
The person.
The person nowadays. And luckily you have freedom and choice about
and better healthcare systems that enable people to push that back. So I mean, it's you can have maybe a complication with a pregnancy or something where you could be older. So, like, my wife, we had Aria, she was 34, I think. So we're thinking about another one, actually. But I mean, I thought the same way. I wasn't interested in having kids. I knew I wanted kids, but not until I was, you know,
ready.
I think men really specifically think about the financial stableness, you know, to be able to, like, and again, that's part of that, like, traditional, I guess I look at it almost like a business in a way where there's a division of labor. So if I can work more and focus on that, then my wife can, you know, be at home with the kids or whatever. We both happen to be home because I work from home, but again, I'm just, from what I hear about people, things seem to be changing in some way that I'm not personally, I guess, knowing much about. So it's nice to get your feedback about what's happening about that.
Yeah, definitely.
We need to get more, like, men over here to explain, like, young men explaining what's happening
on
with
their
that.
Mind.
Yeah, I feel like this age, there's not, I don't know, not looking for anything to just settle down right now. It's more like, hey, let's see what's out there.
Yeah. And if you find somebody that's, like, really good for you, then...
So if you found some guy now that met some kind of criteria, would you settle down, or would you still even then be like, nah, we're going to, like, wait and see, or date him, or for a while or something? Or...
Date for a while. Yeah. Before I really seal the deal.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Same. Like, I'd have to be in my career that I know I want to stay in, or, like, in the same city I know I want to stay in. Like, I'm going to be moving back to San Diego in 4 months, so now I'm just, like, not focused on dating right now. Sure. Like,
yeah, like even in college and I'd work and I'd go to school, I didn't even have time for dating, and all these, you know, a lot of people I knew would go on dates and everything. It just wasn't really until like after graduating college when I got into the, you know, dating scene at first, mm-hmm. and everything. So I don't know, I must be late to the game and everything, but I just feel a lot more focused on like what I, like my, my path and my career and bettering myself, and then whoever wants to come along for the ride, you know?
Yeah. Wow. And I think like a good thing about online dating is you can see on their profile right away, like what kind of relationship they're interested in. If it's casual, short term, long term. And they usually ask like, if you want to have children someday or be married someday. Uh-huh. So you kind of like know what you're getting sure. yourself into. Yeah. But like, I think as we get older too, and you know, do want to find a lifelong partner, like it's important to ask those questions early on in the game. Cause like, if we know we want kids, but like we start dating a guy yeah. who like we find out 6 months after investing our time with him says like, oh, by the way, I'm not too into kids. That's how their voice will sound.
Yeah. Well, it's actually really nice. Some of the guys, like, online dating will, like, right off the bat be like, hey, I'm actually just looking for friends with benefits kind of thing. Yeah. And I'm like, you know what? I like that you're so direct. That. You respect that. Yeah. I'm not interested. But, you know, let them know what you're looking for, you know? Like,
sure.
That was awesome. Like, I might not be interested in that, but
yeah,
it's still... It's almost like auditioning.
Yeah. Well, you're, like, you're okay, looking.
Like, no, sure. you're not right for the role.
Yeah, sorry.
You gotta find. You gotta find what you're looking for. I suppose that makes it easier to narrow your choices down.
Yeah.
What about are you getting any kind of advice or pressure from your parents or like your mothers or saying anything like, why don't you settle down? You know, mm-hmm. you think about having, like, you're not getting any younger, dear. Yeah. You know, like, you get any of that or not?
I have
really?
Family from India, and trust me, they're like, oh, let's do an arranged marriage for you at this point. But it's kind of joking, kind of not, you know, like, I don't really know. Mm-hmm. I think they're kidding, but no, not really. They've never been like, oh my gosh,
strict about that or like,
they're not super, no, they're not really, I mean, for more traditional Indian families, yes, both my roommates are Indian, and, you know, they're very, like, if they're dating someone who's not Indian, they're very, like, hey, I don't want to talk to my family about this even.
Oh, really? Huh.
Yeah. But for me, it's, luckily I've had freedom to kind of do, they trust my decision, and if they're important enough to bring home, I will, and usually they're pretty respectful about that.
So, if your parents, like, if you brought home a guy that your parents didn't like, you wouldn't feel bad about that, you're just like, well, you just gotta... Mm-hmm.
That's actually a really good point now that I think about it. I like, you know, when I go on a date with a guy or like I've been on a few dates, usually I don't let them know, but when I do, I'm like, oh, mom, what do you think of this guy? And she'll be like, it's okay. I'm like, mom, why don't you like them? I want you to like them, especially if like
he's an astronaut.
Exactly. But she's like, Natasha, it's your life. Like, if you like him, then that's fine. But then I'm like, well, I'm already turned off now because I want my mom to love this guy, you know?
It's important to have a family like him.
Yeah.
You think so?
Yeah.
I do think that's important too. I agree with that. Yeah. Then, like, if they do like him, I'm like, all right, he's a good one. I'll keep him around for a while.
So if you maybe, like, there was a guy you liked maybe 80%, but your mom liked him a lot, that would sway that would for you? Yeah.
Add that extra boost, especially when, like, they talk, even before I bring them home or, like, even before I even mention them to my family, like, if they talk about their mom, I'm like, all right, that's so nice. That's cool to hear.
Oh, really?
Bonus points, yeah.
So if you're trying to, how soon or, into the dating or whatever should be, like?
Yeah, not necessarily about their mom, but I guess even about their family in general, just like how close say they that's are.
Important. Them saying family is important.
Yeah,
to them.
Yeah. Like that I don't want to know their detail of their family history. Or like,
I don't need a family tree.
I don't need to like know every detail about your childhood, but like. Just to express your values and to include, like, your relationship with your family and friends is important to me.
Just subtle cues.
Sure, sure. So note to people out there, if you're dating.
Like, don't stop the day and be like, sorry, I got a mom. I mean, I got
my mom's calling.
My mom's calling. I got to answer this. Hey, mom. Yeah. I'd be like, okay.
Or what if, now, what if a guy, like, if a guy walked up to you at the club and he was just like, you know, like, my mom would love you. What would you be?
Would you laugh so hard?
Watch that happen now.
Yeah.
Oh. Try that one out. Like, come out. Like, just bring, carry the photo album with you. Like, this is me when I was five.
Photo albums are on phones nowadays.
Oh, it's, I know. Look at me with like a physical pictures over. I'm old.
That would be even more creepy. Well, this is my photo.
I always think it's so funny. Like back in the olden days, not the olden days, you know, you see in movies like a cute little girl. Grandma, cute little grandpa pulling out their wallet whole long line of like
pictures.
People watching this who are young probably don't even know what I'm talking about. You should show a little picture.
It's interesting. Again, you mentioned something like that. Like when I teach a lot of even just the vocabulary that people have, like we take it for granted even when you're younger. So you learn something like hang the phone up. You're pushing a button on the phone, but it's because, so it used to be up on a wall and you would actually hang something up or like a dial that you would turn on.
That makes sense.
So now it's a switch that you like flip back and forth or push a button. Yeah. But before, I mean, old televisions, like you remember an old television where it just had the power dial was the channel dial.
As well.
So you would turn it on, turn the channel. So we would say turn the channel. Because it was a dial. And so now you're
That for a very short period.
Yeah. So you used to be like that, and you know, but again, we have things like that that come from those olden days, as these young ladies like to call it. But it's great to get your fresh perspectives on what's happening with the dating scene and what men and women are up to these days. I need to get another young buck over here.
Can I say like one pro tip? If I take away anything from this, men or women, like if you just approach somebody and you're genuine, you're not trying to like look for anything out of somebody and just treat them like a person. That's a huge turn on. Like because I feel like attacked if like a guy's being sleazy or I can see in his eyes he like want something more, this is gonna end, and like him asking for my number, it's just like socially exhausting.
You can tell if he's like a hit it and quit it kind of guy or whatever.
Awkward.
It is. Like, or you can see what's happening in their brain. But if you're just genuine, like, hey, what's up? Like, I really like your dress, or I like that tie you're wearing, like. And just like be genuine about it. Don't expect anything. Don't expect anything. That's what I want to say. Don't expect anything from the other person ever. Just be.
If you don't expect anything, you are sure to more successful.
I see. All right. Well, like you men out there, play it safe. Be kind to the ladies, you know, or at least let them know. Like, can I graze your chest or like, you know, something like it. Ask politely. Permission.
Yeah.
But I want to I'll leave it here. There's a lot more that we could talk about, but I think it's a lot of interesting things to jump into there. But I wish both of you well with your respective dating lives and professional lives as well. Well, hopefully I got some interesting vocabulary and tips in there for you, but we'll leave it here for now, and I'll be back in just a minute for the special mission homework assignment. Maybe I'll send you out dating or something like that. Do something interesting.
Check out some apps.
Try this on a date. Hey, Drew, high five.
You could do some. She was telling us.
Ice cream.
Ice cream cone.
I can't see it from that angle.
There you go.
Ice cream cone.
Some different ways of interacting.
Yeah.
With people over here. That might be a generational thing.
Yeah.
See who that works with. But anyway, so we'll close it down for now. And I'll see you back in Zoom. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye.
Well, that's the end of this conversation. I hope you did enjoy it. For your special mission homework assignment tonight or this month, what I'd like you to do, there are actually two things. The first one is just going back and reviewing the conversation because we had a special opportunity this month with two speakers in addition to myself that we get to speak with. So there are lots of opportunities where people are trying to find their turn in the conversation. And this is something that you develop as you speak. It's the same thing in your native language, but there are certain language patterns ways of expressing yourself or certain words that people use right before they're done speaking, or it could be maybe a pause in a thought or something that this gives the other person in the conversation, or if there are more than one person or more than one person in the conversation who are also waiting. So go back and look for this in the conversation, and this is really just to develop that sense of listening for when a conversation point, someone is saying something and then maybe they're going to stop talking so you can make your point after that. But go back and watch when the conversation switches. So the speakers, it switches from one person to the next, and then just go back a little bit and see what was being said right before that happens. Now it happens a lot throughout the conversation, but just pay attention to that. The other part of your homework assignment, more connected with this month's theme is to go out and watch some kind of romantic comedy movie. Now you could watch something maybe even just a TV show, like an episode of some TV show you like that has to do with like a love thing or relationship or dating thing, something like that. But just so you can listen for this kind of vocabulary. So even if you don't understand everything, exactly like we do in Master English Conversation in the Fluency course, what you're really doing is just focusing on one thing at a time. I know you want to be able to use every kind of grammar point very well, or use every kind of phrase exactly when you want to say it, but it takes time to do that. So that's why each month we just focus on one particular grammar point. You focus on that, and then even though there are plenty other grammar points you'll find in these lessons, we just want you to focus on that one. So take your time, really listen for this vocabulary. You could even, you know, take a movie, something like that, and learn it in the same way that you're doing this. So you could just go through a couple of sections of it. Most movies, you can find the script of them online, so you can even search for a particular romantic comedy movie, find the script online, just type in Google or wherever script for, you know, whatever the name of that movie is. And then when you find the script, you can even just do searching for specific words right in that online script. So if you're just looking at it in your browser, you can take some of the vocabulary that you've learned this month in the lessons and then just look for those particular words and then see where that appears in the movie. And then you can go to that section of the movie and watch those things as well. So it should be a lot of fun. And if you can, you can also find fan sites for these kind of movies, or even if you go to imdb.com, this is the Internet Movie Database. And usually you can even start by picking a movie that has lots of people commenting. And you can, again, speak specifically about that movie or talk about maybe something interesting that you liked about it, or ask other fans questions about it. Again, the more you go deep into the conversation, you know, whatever you're talking about, maybe it's a specific movie or something else, it doesn't really matter. But the point is that you're going deeper into that, and that's what's going to get you closer to fluency. Well, that's it for this month. So go back and do those two things. One, again, going back, reviewing the lesson, looking for that where you can get in and out of people speaking because of the specific words they're using, or maybe the pause or the body language that they're using to let the other person know that you can get into the conversation or to start speaking, because one person's not going to say anything after that. And then also look for some kind of romantic comedy movie. So part of that is watching it to get connected with the vocabulary and seeing it in something like a movie. But also, if you can connect with other people, that's ideal as well. So maybe even find some other people who enjoy learning English or just like those kinds of movies and watch it with them and say, hey, like, you know, I want to watch a movie with you, and this could be a great thing to watch. Anyway, that's the end of this lesson. I hope you have enjoyed it, and I look forward to seeing you next month. Bye-bye.